So I'm interested in aerosol particles in the atmosphere, which are small particles, a few hundred nanometers in diameter. They're everywhere around us, and they come from both natural sources and from human activities. The main topic I'm interested in is how aerosol particles affect clouds, and then how clouds go on to affect Earth's climate. The main technique I use is to run simulations with climate models, and these simulations can also be used to predict the weather and to forecast air quality. The main way in which particles influence clouds is that if you have more particles in the cloud gets brighter, and it also sometimes gets less likely to rain. A particular area of interest has been the South Atlantic Ocean, where smoke from Africa mixes into the clouds and changes their properties. In Africa, there are a large number of wildfires and fires from human activities. And these fires generate the world's largest source of smoke aerosol. And this smoke blows over the ocean and then slowly mixes into the clouds as the clouds get deeper and higher towards the middle of the Atlantic. This is particularly important because as the clouds clear towards the western side of the ocean, the transition from cloudy sky to clear sky could be affected by the smoke. And if that's the case, then the smoke would be having a strong effect on the climate, because if you change the amount of cloud cover over the ocean, you change the amount of energy going back to the sun. So the main tool I use for my research is a climate model developed by the United Kingdom Met Office, so the Weather Service of the UK. The way the model works is that the atmosphere is divided into many boxes of a few tens of kilometers, and the height of each box is a few hundred meters. So you can imagine the atmosphere divided in three dimensions into many, many millions of boxes. And each box is simulated, so we simulate the movement of particles from one box to the next, and then we simulate cloud formation in each box, and then we can simulate the particles mixing with the clouds and how the boxes affect the radiation coming into the Earth and the reflectance of the Earth's surface and how much radiation gets back to the sun. When we've done all that, we put all this together to get a energy balance for the Earth, and we can simulate how much energy is reflected from Earth back to the sun over hundreds of years. And this allows us to make predictions about how much the Earth will warm up in the next 100 years for a given input of carbon dioxide. My simulations, I tend to run for only a few weeks, and I tend to run simulations which are back in time a couple of years, centered around measurements taken with aircraft flying through the atmosphere and collecting information about particles and clouds. So this is a really stringent test for the model, because we can compare the predictions of the model to the measurements that were actually made at the time and see how the model gets it wrong or how it gets it right, and then figure out how to improve the model and move forward to better simulations.